Get approved for Google Shopping free listings. In this video, I'm going to cover the important information and what you should be looking out for if you want to set up your products for Google Shopping free listings or you want to be running Google Shopping ads for your Shopify store, WooCommerce store, or just simply your online store. If you're looking for a hands-on tutorial of how you set it up, you can check out my other video on getting your products on Google Shopping free listings. Check out my video here where I have step-by-step tutorial. Link on the top right-hand corner of the screen. Check that out. In this video, I just want to give you some preparation of what you should be preparing for before you actually embark on setting everything up, because you want to get your products and your accounts approved as soon as possible. You want to make sure you have all of this information before you start setting everything up. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. What is Google Shopping free listings? Google Shopping free listings is basically a platform for online store owners to have their products listed there for free. If you have an online store, your products won't be automatically listed there. You have to set it up so you'll be listed on the Google Shopping tab. This is a growing platform for online store owners to have their products listed there, so shoppers or browsers can use that as part of their online shopping journey. Why is Google offering you this feature for free? Google wants to compete with Amazon in the e-commerce space. It's a very big, lucrative, competitive space where Amazon is dominating right now. Google wanted to get store owners to have their products listed there so they can attract the users or shoppers to go to that feature, Google Shopping, to look for products if they want to do online shopping. For Google to succeed in this e-commerce space, Google knows what they have to do exactly to provide that. They want users to keep coming back to their platform to use this feature, Google Shopping, every time they want to shop online. To convince users to do that, what they need to do is to provide a platform where Google users feel that they can trust those products, or they can trust the store owners, or they can trust Google's recommendations. For your products to be listed for free on Google Shopping or to run Google Ads, you have to prove to Google that you are a legit store, you are a store to be trusted, and you are selling products to customers, and those products are of quality so that customers would want to buy from you again and again and again. What does this mean for you if you want to set up Google Shopping? This means that you need to provide as much store information, as much information about your business, your products to Google when you are applying to be listed on Google Shopping. And this also involves setting up 3 tools. Number 1, you need to set up a Google Ads account. Number 2, you need to set up a Google Merchant Center account. And number 3, you need to set up a Google app. If you have a Shopify store, you can use the free Google app. And if you're using WooCommerce platform, you can use the WooCommerce feed manager to set up your product information to send over to Google Merchant Center. Essentially, once you have set up all of this account and provided all the right information, then Google will review your account, review your Google Ads account, review your Google Merchant Center account, and review whether you have set up the apps correctly or the plugin correctly. If you're using BigCommerce, there is also like a feed tool which you can install. So each of them, they are closely related to the Google Shopping. You just need to find the right tool. I'm going to put the link to those tools down in the description and pinned comment so you can check that out, so to make sure that you're installing the right tools for your store. As a store owner, what information do you need on hand before you start setting all of this up? You need to make sure that your store is in top shape. This means that you have your About Us page set up properly, having the right information about who you are as a business owner, what's your business about, maybe even where your business is based. You need a Contact Us page to allow customers to contact you. Make sure you have that page. You need to have one or all of this, that is including the address, the phone number, the email address, your social media handlers, or if you have a WhatsApp, you can also put that in. If you can provide more information, that's awesome, because Google wants to let customers know that your store is easily contactable. So the more contact methods that you have, then Google is happier with your store. Other pages that you need to include as well will be your refunds policy page, whether you offer a refund, and what's your return policy, how can customers return the products to you if there is a defect, or if they change their mind, or if the size doesn't fit. You need to put that into those pages. So make sure you have that. Some people might combine their returns and refund policy into one page, or you can have that separate as well. That's up to you. But make sure you have those information. Shipping policy page, you need to have one of those as well. You need to manage your customers' expectations. Let them know when they should expect their order to arrive, how long it will take to process those orders, whether there's a tracking number, how much would it cost, shipping cost, whether you provide free shipping, or if there's express delivery, then if customers want to pay more to get their orders earlier, that you should also put it all into your shipping policy as well. You also want to provide a secure checkout. Make sure you have those secure checkout or safe website symbols on your store, so customers know that you can be trusted with their private information or with their bank information. So put that in, and if you have multiple payment methods, list that out as well, so customers know how they can pay you, whether they be paying by PayPal, credit card, MasterCard, bank transfer. Put that in. Also make sure that your website is loading properly. Don't let it take too long to load. If you need to compress those images so the store load faster, or to deactivate those apps that are slowing down your store, please make sure you do that as well. The next thing you also want to take note is make sure your store doesn't have error pages and each of your products are listed out properly. If your products are not available for sale yet, then don't list them out. Google doesn't like product pages that are placeholders. Either the product is purchasable or it's not. So you don't have a page that's there that doesn't allow anyone to buy. It's kind of like an empty page. Google doesn't like that either. Also, if you have been developing your site, make sure you have your password removed so anyone else will be able to access the website, especially after you have submitted all your information for this Google Shopping free listing application. You want your store to be accessible by people who are checking your account. So please remove the password before you submit your application. Another thing you want to take note of is to make sure you don't have excessive pop-up. Yes, you can have one or two pop-up if the user arrives on the site, but don't have too many pop-ups that is blocking the user's experience and you're just trying to get the name and address. Google doesn't like that. So make sure you just have the essential pop-up, just one pop-up. Don't have excessive pop-ups blasting in their face, getting them to buy. When you're developing your store, make sure you have a consistent layout. Try to use the same fonts, similar fonts throughout your entire store. Use similar colors. Make sure that your images are of a consistent look and feel across your entire store, because you want to provide a trustworthy environment for the users. Having consistency for those elements gives customers that element of trust. When the Google employee is checking your store for the element of trust, they want to make sure that your products are displayed to the highest quality as much as possible, providing those information needed for a customer to buy from you. Make sure that your product title is properly listed, your product description is available, the image is there. Make sure you have the price and availability listed out, and the currency as well, so Google knows what your store is selling. So if they are clear about what your products are about, then they are confident that customers can trust you. After you have reviewed your store pages and made sure that all of those information that I've highlighted has been listed appropriately on your store pages, then you're good to go. When setting up your Google Ads account, make sure that you're using the same email address that you're using to sign up for your Google Merchant Center account as well, and the same email address that you're using when you install your Google app for your Shopify store or WooCommerce. Make sure that the login is consistent across the three platforms. And when you're filling up your Google Ads account, make sure your time zone, your currency is listed correctly, that is consistent with your store. Also, they will need you to put in your business information, your address, the store name. So make sure that's also consistent with what you have on your store pages, and that's also consistent with your Google Merchant Center business information account. the next thing, for the Google Merchant Center account, there are a few key things that you need to take note. In the settings tab, there are a couple of things you definitely need to make sure that they are filled up correctly. Make sure that your business information, the address, the name of your store is consistent with what you have listed on Shopify, as well as on your store pages. Make sure your address is consistent, your telephone number, the contact name details, put that in. Consistent information throughout the three platforms. That's why I'm repeating it over and over again. It's absolutely crucial. Also, if there's sales tax, do put that into the settings as well. If there's no sales tax, if you're selling in the US, free shopping listings, make sure you set it to zero and make sure that your shipping is set up correctly as well. How much you're charging for shipping, or if you're not, put that information in. The returns policy information should be listed as well. And what's the returns window that your customers are entitled to? Put that in. Remember, that information has to be consistent with what you have listed on your store. Also, make sure the free listing setup is completed, and the shopping ads setup section also has to be completed, even if you don't intend to run Google Ads yet. Within Google Merchant Settings, make sure that this is linked to your Shopify store and it's also linked to your Google Ads page. So make sure the platforms are linked together. And the other thing you need to do once you've completed all the setup is to set up a product feed. So you can either do it manually, which I don't encourage you to do that, or you can set up an automated content feed. So that's going to be really valuable for you, because then all the products, if there are any changes in the quantity of your products or availability, it will automatically be updated in Google Merchant Center. To make sure that your content feed is set up properly, these are the product information that you need to set up. To make sure that your products adhere to Google's guidelines, you need to make sure product information is sent over to Google. The basic information you need is the following five information. You need ID of each of this product. You need your product title, the product description, the image of your product. So if you don't have an image, then that's going to result in error. That's compulsory. You need to have at least one image set up for each of your products. And also the link of your product page. So these are the five compulsory pieces of information. And the next essential information that you need as part of your product feed is the price of each of your product, the availability of your product, whether it's available or it's sold out or it's pending to be available. The third one is the Google product category. Most people don't fill up the Google product category value and allow Google to classify your products for you. I highly recommend you to fill up the information yourself. You can go to look for the Google product categories, what is available, and match the nearest most accurate match for each of your products. When your products are classified correctly, then Google is able to display your products to users by matching their query to specific product categories. So they have an internal algorithm match for you to make sure that you are falling on the right side of Google's categorization. Do it yourself. For more information on how to update your product category or how to look for the information, you can check out my other video right here where I talk about how you can set up your Google product category, link in the top right hand corner of the screen. And the next important information that most people struggle with is the product identifier. Most store owners struggle with this because they don't know what to list. If you're a store owner who manufactures your own product and you haven't actually applied for a barcode for each of your products, then likely you don't have a barcode. But don't worry, you can just put in your brand, which is the name of your store, that's your own brand products, and there's an attribute called identifier_exists. Set that value to no, so you don't have a unique identifier. So you don't have to fill in the barcode, which is the GTIN value. However, if you are getting your products from multiple manufacturers, then you need to get those barcodes from your manufacturers and update it into your Google Merchant Center feed. If you're using the free Google app on the Shopify store, then this information won't be directly flowing through. You need to actually set up a supplemental feed so you can actually upload a CSV file with the Shopify ID and the following barcode. So this information will be integrated into your final product feed. If you also have your manufacturer part number or your SKU number, do make sure that this information is also provided to Google, because if you provide all this information, then Google will deem your store as a trustworthy store, providing every piece of detailed information about your products. So that would be useful to getting your approval as well. The last category of product information is the detailed product information. So in this particular category, it could vary what is the information that's needed by Google depending on what type of products you are selling. If you are selling clothing and accessories, then there are certain attributes that's compulsory for your submission as well. That is, for example, like color. The color of your shirt, the color of your shorts, the color of your dress, gender. So if your cloth or your accessories is meant for male or female or unisex, age group, whether is it for kids or like babies, infant, adult. So you want to fill up your age group. If you want to help shoppers find your products more easily and you have those information at hand, you could also include, for example, like the material of your product, if there are any patterns, or if you're selling products that are bundled together, you can put those information in as well, because the more information you provide, you can help shoppers to find what they want more easily. Don't forget to list down the size of your product as well, if that's one of your variants. And of course, if you are looking at, let's say, furniture, having those detailed dimensions information means that Google is able to show the correct measurement of the products as close to the match of what a user is looking for. So that means it's a bonus for you if you provide as much information for users to be able to discover your products on Google Shopping. There's another attribute that you need to submit as well, which is the item group ID. If you have multiple variants of the same product, for example, different colors of the same product, then you want to have the same item group ID for them. If you are providing more information, getting more matches, so you're getting more clicks, then ultimately your products can go higher and higher up listed on Google Shopping. I hope this video has been useful for you. What I'm trying to do over here is to highlight what is Google's goals, what is Google's expectations of you as a store owner if you want to get your products listed for free on Google Shopping, and why or how you can provide those information to Google so you'll be able to get your account approved as soon as possible without being frustrated by all the disapproval and suspension issues that many other store owners are facing, because they are not actually putting much thought into the setup process. Because it takes a long time for Google to actually re-review your account if you get it disapproved the first time. So I hope with this video, you get a good idea of what you actually need, and you can provide as much information as possible so Google knows that they need to have your store products listed on Google Shopping to provide the best experience options for their customers. Once you get your account approved, then yay, you'll be able to get a nice flow of users from Google Shopping to your store. So that's going to help you greatly. The more traffic sources you have, then you won't be dependent on one traffic source. I always recommend store owners never to put their eggs all into one basket. You should explore different traffic sources as much as possible, and you try to diversify. If you also want to learn of alternative ways to drive more traffic to your store, whether it is free or paid, then you definitely need to download my Shopify marketing guide, link in the description and pinned comments, where I explore the pros and cons so you know which of these options that would work best for you. Do download that. And if you want to get one-on-one help to get more traffic and sales for your store, you want to work with me, then you can check the link down in the description and pinned comments. I work with Shopify store owners to explore different ways of driving traffic and to fine-tune your marketing strategy. If you need a review of your Google Merchant Center account or Google Ads account, you can also get in touch with me. And if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, please remember to give it a like, subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos on how to get more traffic and sales for your Shopify store by getting on Google and YouTube page one. I'm Clarice Lin, ROI Doctor, signing off. I'll see you in the next video.